Fudge, that one was big.
So we got our new crop in the mail.
He senses my South Africa. He knows.
Hey, Lucy.
Hi, Lucy. Look at you.
Lucy? Oh, Lucy. <That one's mine.
laughs> Yeah, no.
They're going to bite you.
We bought an old abandoned catamaran. Spent 2 years rebuilding her and embarked on a 7,000-mile journey across the Atlantic Ocean to our dream cruising grounds, the beautiful Caribbean.
Subscribe below and follow the adventure as we explore our way up the Caribbean chain of islands to the beautiful Bahamas.
Being stuck in Grenada for hurricane season meant getting daily routines, and one of those routines happened to be playing volleyball.
So it's Volleyball Wednesday, and we're on our way to go play some volleyball. It's something to do that keeps us active and off the boat, and it's a lot of fun. We get to meet new people.
So we're going with our friends.
So one thing Ricky really loves to do is feed the little fish outside at night time. Yeah, you do. You love feeding little fish.
Me entertained.
So we still have a bunch of bait that we caught when we first got you.
Yeah.
We had frozen, so we just cut one of them up and gonna go feed the fish.
Got all in at once. So I cut a small one up. And pretty much like chum. Like one or two dark shadows at the bottom, so I want to see if they want to come up. So we'll see. Let's chuck it in. See if we can get them into a feeding frenzy. And see if they, the big boys will come up. Might be worth it to chuck a line down. What are they called? Black tip kingfish. These all look like jacks. These are definitely part of the kingfish.
So that's what they look like.
We did Google them the other day. What are they? Something jacks.
Are those the ones we ate?
Yeah, same. This is what I'd caught previously.
Oh.
They're something jacks. It's not a sardine or something. Might look similar to a sardine, but it's not at all. Doesn't taste the same either. What do you think is going to happen?
Who knows? They don't touch it?
No, they sniff it. They haven't hit it at all.
Nope.
That was really uneventful.
Sorry, I...
Small little suckers don't want to eat big fish.
That same evening after settling down, we experienced some lightning and thunder. It was our first time experiencing it, and now we understand what the fuss is about. It's pretty darn scary on a boat.
Yes! You feel it shaking the hull. Never felt it like that before.
Yeah, I know. It's wild. You can't even see the boats. It's just like mist.
Ooh, shit.
Fudge, that one was big.
Like right above us.
So we got our new crop in the mail yesterday along with all our insulation, so we can get started on insulating the boat again and finishing up that job, and then we're gonna go to the beach and then replace our prop finally after how many months? Three months of having a messed up prop. So we're gonna get that done, and then hopefully the speed and everything around dinghies maybe a little bit faster. Wishful thinking.
Oh, we do need fuel.
This thing's so economical, keep on forgetting fuel. There's like nothing.
Are we gonna make it home?
Yeah, we'll make it home.
But we have to make it to the dinghy dock as well.
Yeah.
We need to go get fuel.
We always forget about our fuel.
Because the thing needs to sell fuel.
Always.
That tank like lasted us like
Well, this to change this prop is super easy. Just take out this pin. Grab this here.
Turn it.
Yeah. Take this end cap out and prop off. See what it, see there? I drilled a hole there and I put a pin and then I cut it off.
And it's lasted, eh?
Yeah.
I did a good job then.
It's not ideal to do something like that, but we had no other choice.
Yeah. If you bust the prop and like you spun it and there's no other option.
Woo! Ooh.
Yeah, then you can do that. Had a little muscle growing on it. Yep.
There be any performance differences with the new prop?
We should get a little bit. This one should give us a little bit more RPM. So hopefully it gives us better performance. And obviously it would be better balanced because there's no pinning on it. Athlon marine boots.
We have some on the inside of the prop so it don't get some growth.
And we've got to look after this engine and this dinghy because at the moment there's not budget to get a new one. And she's been really good to us, so we're gonna take real good care of her. You got the pin?
Yeah.
That's it. Prop change.
New prop. Yeah, yeah.
Don't forget to subscribe below if you haven't already and click on the notification bell to alert you when we upload a new episode and like this video as well as share it with your friends and family. It's a free way you can support our channel.
How's cleaning the boat with this bloody surge? Yeah. Getting knocked over by the dinghy in the water. But bottom's clean, so I think we're good, eh?
Good to go.
Good to go.
Put the engine back on.
Test our new prop.
Our dinghy was clean again. Now we just had to pick some growth off our outboard and we would be good to go to test our new prop. If you made up your mind
to leave this behind. And when we haul out the boat, I'm going to put some anti-fouling on the leg. Give it a good clean. If my eyes can't convince you that I'm still in love since you first took my hand on that sweet summer night. And if your heart can't trust me, then I'll say this must be the start of a sin.
Dropped everything off back at the boat and headed off to get some more fuel.
So we're gonna go get some fuel because we're out of fuel for the dinghy. But what a difference that prop makes,
yep.
Eh?
So if you guys buy a prop, 7.5 by 6.5 for a Suzuki 6 horsepower, it's perfect. It's super. That's the best performing prop we've had so far.
Woo! The dodgy dock. But yeah, no, frick, huge difference. We probably won't have to upgrade anymore.
No, we still need to upgrade.
Ricky said we still need to upgrade. But yeah, no, that was a huge difference. We got into plane. We were going against the wind and we were still getting some good speed. So I'm glad that we managed to get a new prop again.
I don't even know whose helmet's whose because we've
been... That's yours, mine's been scratched.
Everyone's been wearing each other's helmets today. Fuel can there.
Let's go!
Back road or main road?
The nicest road.
Gotta
take a few
waves. Today's Friday, so it's like mad out on the roads. Everyone forgets how to drive on the road.
I hope I'll learn there for a fight.
Yeah.
Because like it's the worst time to drive right now, and they're into the school. Because it's a little tough getting used to driving in Grenada.
We stop by our fruit and veg lady to stock up with our favorite fruits and veg for the week. After dropping everything off at the boat, we headed out to dinner.
So we hit the container park getting some food, and the container park is pretty much a bunch of containers that have different food, what do you call it? Food stores in it.
Yeah.
Yeah, with our Colombian friends. What are you guys gonna eat?
I don't know.
I don't know either. What are you gonna eat, honey bun?
Honey bunny.
Filthy mouths.
You guys, thank you. So sweet.
Oh.
What a darling you are. Do you say darling in South African?
Hey darling.
Hey darling.
That's British.
Oh, that's British?
We ran into Lucy, the friendliest rooster you'll ever meet.
How do I know when I can pay
him? Lucy's checking it.
Lucy, can I pay you? Okay, normally dogs, I would put my hands so they smell me and I don't know how to ask.
Yeah, he would probably go for your bracelet. Like, he's, you know, he's not gonna bite me, but...
Hi, Lucy, you want some rice?
Here
you
go.
What?
No,
like that?
Lucy!
Here you go! Thank you. Oh, he's so nice. Hello. You are such a good rooster. Oh, she does?
Me.
Oh, wow.
He senses my South Africa. He knows.
Hey, Lucy.
Hi, Lucy. Look at you.
Hi, Lucy. Cutie.
Those are some big nails. That's how they fight, right? Like,
yeah. What's your Instagram? Your Instagram?
For Lucy.
I love Lucy.
Heard it. If you want to follow the chicken we saw, it's Lucy.
It's Rooster.
I love Lucy. 473.
Yeah.
Oh, that's when he was a baby.
Oh, he was pretty.
And
young.
I got
pork. So cute.
He was pretty ugly. Oh, he
was
a chicken. Barely had any feathers. You know?
Barely any feathers, Lucy has.
So Ricky moved Alejandro and Andrea's scooter. Is it in Bay? And we're gonna see if it gets stressed out.
If the steering wheel wasn't locked, I would have moved that thing like
really far.
Way gone.
But yeah, we're gonna...
That's what you get for being late, suckers.
That's what you get for being late. We had plans to be on the dock at 8 to go to the nature reserve and then go up to the waterfalls. I couldn't think of the word. The waterfalls. Remember that time that we said we went to the waterfalls and lost all our footage? So we're going back to that waterfall because I think it's one of the best ones.
Take two.
Yeah, we're gonna hopefully capture all the footage to show you how beautiful that hike and the waterfall itself is. And then yeah, so it's gonna be a jam-packed day. Got lots of sunscreen on since we're taking the scooters up there, so we're gonna be in the sun all day and get some snacks.
See, Colombians could be Portuguese. You'd swear they're part of my family already. Always late. I see. I see you got your captain shirt on. That means business, baby.
You guys ready for adventuring?
So ready.
You guys got your costumes on? Leandro, you bring your little thong?
Wait, what?
No, your thong? Is this ready before?
Oh, no, I forgot, but I have to go back to the boat.
Why?
I forgot my thong.
Is this cool? It was right there just a few minutes ago. When we walked the dog.
What? What's missing?
You moved it.
No, dude. Yeah,
dude, did. We just gotcha. With you guys.
What happened? We took our scooter.
You stole a scooter?
Yeah.
Our scooter?
Yeah. So why would... You think they moved it?
Because you're late, bitches.
You're late, bitches.
What did you just do?
You're lucky that the steering
wheel. It was locked. We were going to move it.
I know. We're walking
here and we only see his scooter.
But it's locked to the one side,
and
so I had to like move it back.
We need a new thing.
We're the biker clan, the scooter clan. Ricky's always wanted a scooter clan. Now he finally has it. We just need to get the leather jackets made. Grenada scooter clan.
We gotta get our patches.
We gotta get our patches for our leather jackets. Let's do this!
I hate
you.
We're
always letting the
park. I love it. I do it too. It's fun. You ready? Go. You got everything?
Like mice.
Let's go.
We were pretty excited to explore the island via scooter and get to see all the things we missed before.
We get high up in the mountains, you can feel the temperature dropping.
Our first stop on our road trip was to go see the Mona monkeys and get our monkey fix. Seeing these cuties would make any bad day 10 times better.
What's up, people? This is epic on a scooter, man. Way better than doing it in a car.
Way better.
You're like, you're like in it. You're smelling it, you're feeling it, you're getting chilly.
Ricky loves the fur.
Oh man, they go crazy.
Babes, break the banana small. Where's the bananas?
They're going crazy for Simone.
For the bananas.
Where's the other bananas?
The amateurs, come, I'll show you in monkey.
They attacked me, yeah. I couldn't hold myself.
Like they're hungry. Should we see?
No, you see.
That one's mine. Yeah, no.
They're
one.
Gonna bite this you.
Look, he's fighting his
thank you. Oh, it's so easy.
Hide the bananas in your pockets.
Put them in your pocket.
Hold that on there.
No, no.
Yeah, yeah, let him take it now. Watch it.
Wait. He just left the banana.
Wait, I have to, I'm gonna spread it over multiple.
No! Ow. No!
Oh shit, they're gonna fight.
Hey!
Oh shoot, they're going for
real. Honey!
Oh! You want it? Hold on.
Your butt.
You have to be kind. You have to say please.
You like the butt?
They're wild.
Look at you sitting.
Yeah.
What's up, man?
Look at you being Dr. Doolittle.
Yoga. Yoga poses.
Dr. Doolittle.
Doolittle.
Like that?
Come here, we can be friends.
You're gonna check in
we
your pants.
It's like, don't.
You got a friend in me.
You like me?
Yeah.
We can be friends.
Honey.
I would have a monkey. But monkeys, you'd love the wild, right? Oh, wait here. I might have something for you. In my pocket.
Wouldn't a monkey be cool as a boat pet?
Yeah, we're in Benelux. We just climb up
check
the mountain.
Watch it, checking it.
Check my pockets.
Riding the scooter. Monkey riding the scooter.
Vroom vroom. What are you eating out of my shoe, buddy? Check. Oh, he's checking himself out. Who's that handsome dude?
He's checking himself in the mirror.
Who's that handsome dude? It's you! Oh, he's only coming for you. Other.
He wanted to open the thing.
He's like, he knows the banana lives underneath this thing.
It fell out.
What do you do?
You put it like inside the shirt. Like
I'm just going on earth.
Hey.
He's also looking now.
He's like, what's that? He's like, is there something in there? If there's a banana in there, I need to get it.
Oh, the little one got it.
They got it?
Yeah, the little one at the back got it.
With the monkey.
Woo! Oh, <my God. laughs>
That was insane.
That was crazy.
Did you get that?
I'll take that. Had a good time feeding all the monkeys. And now we only got three monkeys here busy making sounds. Three baboons. That was pretty good. We'll show you what happened when we get back. Like literally, once we finished feeding them, it's just like a freaking busload of people there now. Tons. And not one monkey is coming down because they've been fed too much already.
Stay tuned till next week as we go hiking up to the waterfalls and use the rain to our advantage. Don't forget to subscribe below if you haven't already and give this video a big thumbs up. See you guys next week!